Hello everyone, and welcome to the lecture on indexing and slicing two-dimensional arrays. In the last lecture, we saw how we can index 1D arrays. And in this lecture, we'll see slicing and indexing in two-dimensional arrays. Let's start by creating a two-dimensional array, and we'll save it in a variable called array2. So np.array, and we'll pass a list of elements. Let's say 2, 4, and 6 for our first list. Let's pass 3 more lists. Second one, 1, 3, and 5 for our third element. For our third list, let's pass 22, 23, and 34. And for our final list, we'll pass the elements 13, 15, and 19. So if we look at our array2 object, we have a 4x3 two-dimensional array. So array2 dot number of dimensions and dim, we see that it's a two-dimensional array. So we can do indexing similar to one-dimensional arrays. So this will be the first list will be index 0, and then this will be index 1, 2, and 3. So if we pass index 0, it will grab us a list containing the elements 2, 4, and 6. So array2 at index 0, that will be, it will give us an array containing the elements 2, 4, and 6. Similarly, we can say array2 at index 2, that will give us 22, 23, and 34. We can also do negative indexing. Array2 at index, let's say negative 2, that will give us, so this will be negative 1, so the end will be negative, indexing starts from the end, so that will be index position negative 1, and then this will be negative 2. So far, we are grabbing just the external lists, right? So we are grabbing this as one element. We're grabbing this list as an element. What if we want to grab, let's say, this element 4 from this list? So we have to apply a second level of indexing. So this indexing, the indexing that we have seen so far, those are first level of indexing. So think of it like the outer indexing. Now we have to grab an element within that list. So how can we do that? We can simply do that by passing an additional indexing, a second level indexing. So we have our array2 object. We want to grab the element 4, right? Initially, we have to grab this list, this whole list, which is at index 0. So we'll pass index 0. And then within that list, so that will give us this array containing a list of elements 2, 4, 6. And to grab 4 from this list, we apply another indexing, additional indexing. So 4 is at index 0, 1. So we simply pass an additional index of 1. So that will give us 4, right? Let's look at another example. Let's say we want to grab 13 here. How can we do that? So 13, initially we have to grab this list. So that's at index 0, 1, 2, 3. So array2 at index 3, that will give us what? An array containing that list. And then if we apply, so 13 is at index 0, right? So if we pass 0, we'll get 13. And another way we can do it is, let's say array 2 at index 3. So that will give us the outer array, right? And if we save this in a variable called, let's say x, now if we call x, we have an array containing 13, 15, and 19. That's x. And we can simply apply an index on our array x. So here 13 is at index 0. So we can simply pass 0. And then we get the same result. Good. So this is one way of accessing an element in a two-dimensional array. Another way is as follows. Let's say we want to grab 23 here. So 23 is at index. Initially, we get the index of this list, which is at index 0, 1, and 2. So index 2. Array 1 at index 2. And then within that list, 23 is at index 0, 1, at index 1. So the way we have seen so far is we simply pass 1. But instead of that, or let me show you. So we get array 2. Oh, sorry, this is array 2. Our object is array 2, not array 1. So that will give us 23. Similarly, the other way I wanted to show you is like this. So index 2, array 2 at index 2, comma 1. That will also give us 23. Okay, this is the common way, but I just wanted to show you that there is also another way. So instead of passing one index and then an additional index, we can also say 2, comma 1. But I think the first way is more common and it's easier. The meaning is much more clearer and direct than this method. But I just wanted to show you that there's also this method. We can also do slice indexing on two-dimensional arrays. We can also say array 2 from index, let's say 1, 2, 3. So it will get an array containing a list of elements from index 1 to 3. That means indexes 1 and 2. So it will grab, this is index 0, this is index 1, and index 2. So I'll get these two lists as an array. So if we run this, we get those two lists. Similarly, we can do array 2 from index 2 to 3. So this is index slicing. And we get a list containing the elements 22, 23, and 34. We can also do array 2, let's say up to index 3. This means grab indexes 0, 1, and 2. So basically the first three lists of the array. Good. Now let's take this to the next level. So what if we want to grab, for instance, elements, the first two elements in each of our array lists here? So let's say we want to grab 2 and 4, 1 and 3, 22 and 23, or 4 and 6, 3 and 5, 23 and 34. How can we do that from our array object? So let's look at our array 2 object one more time. So how can we grab that? Let's say I want to grab the elements 4 and 6, so the last two elements from each listing my array. So let's say we want to grab 4 and 6, 3 and 5, 23 and 34, and 15 and 19. How can we do that? So we can say array 2. And then first we have to grab everything, right? So that means we can simply say colon. That means grab all the indexes, then comma, and then within each list, grab the last two elements. So in this case, it will be, this is index 0, this is index 1, this is index 2. So we can say index 1 onwards. That means index 1 and every index after 1. So if we run this, we get the elements containing the last two elements in each of the list. What if we want to get, let's say, 4 and 6 and 3 and 5 only? How can we do that? So for that, first we have to grab the first two lists containing the elements. So we say we have our array 2, and then in the first indexing, we are only grabbing the first two elements, right? The first two lists. So that will be, this will be index 0, this will be index 1. So we only need indexes 0 and 1. So I can say up to index 2. That means grab index 0 and 1. Comma. And then if we want the element 4 and 6 and 3 and 5, we can simply say they are at index 0, 1, and 6. So we can simply say 1 onwards. Or, so that will give us 4 and 6 and 3 and 5. Let me run it and show you. So 4 and 6 and 3 and 5. And if we want to grab the first two elements, let's say 2 and 4 or 2 and 4 and 1 and 3, we can simply say, so 2 and 4 and 1 and 3 are at index 0 and 1, right? So we can say up to index 2. That means grab indexes 0 and 1. So that will give us 2 and 4 and 1 and 3. 2 and 4 and 1 and 3. Okay, let's look at one more example. What if we want to grab only the middle elements? Let's say I want to grab 4, 3, 23, and 15. So how can we do that? So for that, we can say array 2, and then in the first level of indexing, we want to grab the middle elements from each of the lists in my array. So we'll pass colon, that means every index. And then from the second, for the second indexing, we need indexes what? 0, 1. We need index 1. So if we run it, we get 4, 3, 23, and 15, right? 4, 3, 23, and 15. Or we could have also said array 2, everything, and then index 1 to 2. That will give us 4, 3, 23, and 15 from each list containing the elements. So depending on the result that you want, you can either use this method or you can specify it as a slice. So this will give you each element as a slice. One last thing I want to show you is that we can also assign a new value to a slice. So let's say we want to assign new values to these elements in our slice. So instead of 2, 4, and 1, and 3, let's say we want to assign new values to this slice. So we can simply say, I'll just copy and paste this. So let's look at our array to object. So this indexing, this slicing up to two will give us 2 and 4, and then 1 and 3. Now we can set this slice and then set it to be equal to, let's say, 122. So we can assign a new value like that. That way, when we call the array, it will have this new value. Let's look at that. Now, if I call my array 2, you see the values here are now 122. So to summarize, we saw how we could do slicing and indexing in two-dimensional arrays. We saw that we have to apply two levels of indexing to obtain or grab a single specific element within a list in our array. Thank you, everyone, and I'll see you at the next lecture.